All right, today I'm just going to talk a little about the market. I'm in here looking at some. Oh, I don't know what I'm. I was. I had a few things that were interesting lately. I was looking at the Hershey Company, believe it or not. I thought that was kind of something that had fallen, pretty far. I don't know if it's the end of its fall, but it was something I was interested in. So yeah, I'm trying to just take off all of that, so you don't have to see all that. It gets annoying. So right now it's at 179. I think I got in at 180 or something. So now it's really clunking down even further. It does have potential, though. They do have a good target. To go quite high over, past 200 by the end of the year or within 12 months. So it's not like a dead dying company thus far. So that's something to consider, and it's kind of an interesting one because it's Christmas. Now what I really wanted to talk today about was dividends. There's some dividend little things, and this is on Street Smart Edge, which they're phasing out. And I don't, like I said, maybe there are people that can have enough money to say, well, there's like 6 trillion traded on this one, and there's only 1 trillion traded on the crappy other thinkorswim. So one would think that this one would be superior and you wouldn't dump it. But apparently they are going to dump this one and take the one that less people trade on, that has less money traded through. So I think they're trying to turn the market. I think they're trying to upset it. I think they're trying to create a fall at that time. So just be prepared. They say we have like 3 months or 60 days, I'm sorry, to switch. And during that 60 days, I imagine the market is not going to do very well. And that's my take on it, because that's a lot of money out there that they're just trying to pull the carpet away from and say, hey, switch to our platform, and you better wear our blue suede shoes or else. And it's just going to be people learning all of a sudden again, and they're not going to want to. They're going to be reticent. They're going to say, hey, I want to sue you. It's just going to be a nightmare. So, what an idiot Schwab. That's all I have to say. What an idiot Schwab. Rather than take this particular platform and just say, hey, we'll modify it and update it. It's great as it is. It's colorful, it's vivid. Older people can use it because of that. And instead, they're switching us off to all white. Where here you're going to have all of this coming in as white, and maybe you get green and red, and you can maybe change the green and red to peach and blue or something, but you can only change the up and down price in color. You're not going to be able to change anything else, so it's going to be very hard on our eyesight. Okay, so anyway, so we're looking at Hershey now. That was interesting. But anyway, what I was really trying to get to today was dividends, and not be such a thrown into bitch tantrum, because that's all this life seems to be, is a bitch tantrum over what the banks are doing next. Okay, so right now we have two things with dividends. You have dividend yield, and then you just have dividend. Now, dividend is nice because that tells you the dividend per share, but the dividend yield is based upon the price. Like, let's say you're buying Microsoft, and it's actually doesn't pay dividends. Let's say you're buying something that's $100 or over $100 a share, or into it here. This one is like 500, isn't it? Into, I think so. Yeah, I think it's like a $500 stock. So let's say you're buying that. Well, it's only going to pay you $3.60 per share. So in the long run, your yield is only going to be, here, let me widen that. Your dividend yield is only going to be 0.58, which is actually quite low. So that's something to really think about is your dividend yield. I have one here that's outstanding, and I'll put this as the top of my list, which is going to be BTO right now, which is something that you can get into if you want, but be prepared there's no leverage on it. It's not anything you can use with margin. It really has to be from your maintenance account. So the money that you put out on it, because it's a crypto EFT, has to be your $100 is your $100. You're not going to get any leveraging. So as wonderful as this dividend is, and it is really helping it, this EFT grow throughout. So it's amazing, that type of a yield, and it pays every month. So it's a monthly one as well. So it's really something to look at and go, do I want to try it out? Anyway, so it is BITO is the symbol. And right now it's at an all-time high, and it probably will only ever be at an all-time high. Right now it just seems to be growing and growing because it's paying excellent dividend every month. 13.86 yield. I mean, that's incredible. So now next, I have here on my list, I have T, which is AT&T. That's a really high yield player also. And now that one you can use on a leverage account, a marginable leverage account. Yeah, apparently I'm a racist because my hair goes straight up. I only have a few hairs, you know, that's what they do. All right. Okay, so next we're gonna go with the dividend on that one. It only is going to pay you $1 per, over the year, over the time. I believe that one's a year, and I think this one's a quarterly. Unfortunately, this doesn't say quarterly or monthly or anything like that, but you know, so you have to do that type of research and find out which ones. But this is a very good player when you're looking at the yield, because it's a real a stable company, you know. Another one here that's high. These ones, now this one I'm not really happy with because it was so good for so long, and then it just tumped, and it tumped and tumped. So when you're thinking about a you know, like Citibank, they ended up having to close a whole bunch of, I guess they were their internationals. So a lot of international firms or something, they ended up having to close a bunch of those. So there's something that be careful with, you know. I mean, all of these are be careful with, of course, and especially even the crypto. The crypto could just turn around and go sour on you. So you could buy into it, you could be paid your dividend, but your initial investment can go sour. It's always a way with dividends. And of course, it can change the yield that you're going to get, or the price per. Anyway, so these are my high highs here. And I have Hershey, apparently. This one I just was into, and all of a sudden it's going to pay a dividend. So that's kind of neat. I don't think it pays very often. It looks like it's a quarterly, yeah, it's a quarterly dividend, paid 1.19 last. So something to consider. That's kind of cool. So anytime something like that shows up, but the yield over the year, remember it's a very high price stock. It's at 178 right now because I bought it at 180. So it's a very high price stock, and so it's going to lower that yield quite a bit versus what they're paying out. Another one that's pretty stable is Cisco. And Cisco, it's kind of a boring stock to trade. You can get into it. Let's check it out today. I think it's pretty sustainable, though. I mean, it did have this massive drop out of the 50 range here. It was in the 53. That was pretty devastating. I can't remember why, but there was some news. And it's been trying to build back ever since. When it gets back up there again, I don't know. But it does pay dividends, and it does pay good ones. Here it was paying 39, and based upon its 49 a share. So here we have the yield on it at 3%. Yeah, so this is just something to always to consider. And now I'm also, and before I'm getting into all always consider, I think USB was a really good one also as a bank. Let's look at that one. And I don't think I have a Bank of America. Oh, Bank of America has one also. It's not paying as great as USB. Now USB is way the heck up there. What's been going on with it? It's really had a steady climb. I don't know how to get that chart. There we are. It's over there. Yeah, it's had a steady climb for a while. So it's really at an all-time high, and everybody's probably thinking it's reversal, it's reversal, everything ever has to reverse. The banks are too high. Schwab did try to take, has been making pullbacks, and so has USB in recent days. If it's gonna maintain, more of a pullback, I don't know. But if you look at the uprise of this, like if you're making a trend line through, it looks like it is about to cross that trend line. It's at the trend line, depending on how you draw it. Maybe a bounce off the trend line. So it's kind of at a pivotal. If you're a trend line human. Yeah, but either way, with it pays really good as far as its dividends. Now, when do the dividends pay? That's another thing to look into. Let's look at what else we've got on the dates here. Now we have some. Do we have anything this year? Is anything still out there? Yes, USB is still out there, and it's going to pay this particular 28th. That's its expiry date. So when that expires, I don't actually know the pay date right now. It's probably 10, 20 days after that, but there it is. So you're going to have an expiry on the 28th. So if you wanted to buy a stock with a dividend, that's one that you can get into. You'll definitely be paid the dividends. And so it all helps when you're making that process decision. Who else is lined up next? Now, the high player T is, and that one's lined up for the 9th. So 6.78 yield so that's a couple weeks away though, 2.5 weeks away. So it's up to you when to buy. It's just something to consider. It's like if I'm going to get into it now, if I'm going to buy this now, if I'm going to buy the where are we at the USB right now. Ideally, I would like to get it at a lower price, or I would have already purchased it. But you don't always have that ideal. I mean, if the thing keeps going, and this is more like a bounce off the trend line, then you may not get a better buy for that dividend on the 28th. It's just the way it goes. But we have had a lot of updates. So I'm not really, what do you call it? Ecstatic about this so-called up move because we've had so many up days, and after the last couple years, they've been very traumatic. So it's kind of difficult to trust another up day and another up day and another up day. And yet that's what we've been going through for many almost weeks now. It's become difficult to stomach, actually. We have another one coming up due, and that would be GPS to consider, which is the gap. So yeah, these are all kind of good ones. We have Cisco also. So Cisco is another high player on the dividends. Not high, super high, but at least it's something. And that one is coming through on the third. So second and the third, and we have T on the ninth. And SBUCKS. Now SBUCKS does pay them out, but not it's not going to start expiring until February. So, and it pays all right. It's not the greatest. And look at Microsoft. I wouldn't really jump and say, "Hey, I'm buying Microsoft just to get the dividends back." You know, I would never do that. It's only paying you 0.81. If you're going to trade Microsoft, trade Microsoft to trade Microsoft. Don't trade it for its dividend. The it's way too steeply high. It's at the 300. Maybe it'll go to 400, but via comparison, you're just not going to get a good yield out of it. You choose something else. You can look at Apple. And that's the same situation. A 0.5, you're only going to get a yield of a 0.5 out of it. I mean, to me, that's nothing. So, I would if you're going to trade Apple, trade Apple to trade Apple. You can look at other banks. You can look at Schwab. Schwab is giving out a 1.48. That's kind of small. Bank of America gives more than that, so I don't know why Schwab is so stingy, considering it trades trillions of dollars, or something like 7, 8 trillions of dollars every day. I'm believing it. No, it has in assets. I'm sorry, in tradable assets. So it has a huge amount in these assets that are just hanging out there, and we're all like, well, you could pay a little more on that, but it hasn't. It's still slumping down at even though it's at a high peak right now. We'll check it out. I know it doesn't look like it's at a high peak, but it is. After it was down in the 40 range. So anyway, we're it went up to 70s, and now it's at the 60, 67. It had a pullback there to 67, and it's starting to say maybe that's all right. I don't know. Why did it stop? We don't know. It made a resistance point. Sorry, found a support point right here, so that's great. And we'll see what happens if it keeps this sliding on itself or whatever. Yeah, but as a trend line, I'm not one of those fast trend line drawer types, but it broke it there, here. So then after that break, it started another fresh trend line, and it went up to this one, and it broke it. So it has broken that trend line. It was a very steep one. You can always go back to this one, though, and say, well, I'm just gonna go up that trend line that way. So it's under, it hasn't broken it yet. It's not even near it. So in the long-term trend line of a couple months, it looks like maybe around, if it gets to around 66 or something, it might start breaking at 65, 66. Anyway, that's all I have today. Was there anything else? Yeah, I don't actually think airlines, I have AAL there. I don't think airlines are paying. I don't see any airlines paying. There might be one, you'll have to seek them out. But normally airlines should. I would think they would be something. We have a hotel here that pays, but it's very small. It's not worth it. This is, I believe, Hilton or Hyatt. Yeah, this one does not pay very well. Here's another one. This is a bank. This is Goldman Sachs. Now that pays all right, 2.92. Its dividend looks really amazing, but I believe it's a $300 price stock. So you know that goes hand in hand. Yeah, 378. So technically that and Microsoft should be paying the same. Microsoft is in the same range here at 370, and the dividend out $3 to 11. I mean, that's just not even comparable. So if you're just in the dividend market, really look at the yield. The yield is extremely helpful. And yeah, especially if you can see it. Okay, so I'll try to smile. I have a happy house full of doggies. We're having a wonderful Christmas. Labradoodles and huskies. And a really, really happy Labrador. They're all happy dogs, every single one. So I really lucked out this year. There's nothing more I can say about that, except it rained so much last night that they don't want to go outside. Nobody wants to go outside. It's just like a pond. They don't want their feet wet, especially the Labradoodles. A lot of them, they have like fur that comes through on the bottom, and then there's their pads, and so that fur has to be clipped. And I actually might do that. I might trim the fur of this one dog so when he walks, he doesn't step in everything wet all the time, because that can give him infection. But yeah, they don't want to go out. They don't even want to go on a walk. So it's just like the dampness, it brings like their fur down. Huskies hate the rain. They don't want to be in it. They're just scared of it. They run away. And Labradoodles, I find that the same. So it's kind of interesting. And I have a Labrador that is not allowed to play with a tennis ball because he swallowed one once. So he has a huge, huge mouth, and so he's not like a normal size lab. He's massive. So that's something to think about if you have an extra large dog, is make sure you have the large enough balls for them to play with. So anyway, that's it for today. I think I gave a lot of good information. It's really about these. Okay, who's we have you have Harley Davidson pays 1.87. That's not bad as a yield. I'm not gonna say hey, that's marvelous. Even Walmart pays in that same range. But yeah, try to think of something. And now we have eBay that stepped into it, and it also pays. So there's a few out there. And even gold will pay. So you've got some interesting ideas, but if you look at it, some of them are paying double and triple. And then there's that big crypto out there. Because if you ever wanted to trade crypto, but you don't want to trade crypto, that BITO is a good option as an EFT. All right, anything else? No, that's it for today. I'm gonna sign off.